everyone, welcome to another Tech Saturday with Eric and Keith. In this one, we're going to talk filters for your GoPro. Specifically, we're going to talk about these. It's the Venture 3 Pack from PolarPro. Do you really need this for your GoPro, or do you just shoot stock? You got to stick around and find out. Also, don't forget to like, share, and leave us a comment down below. And also, don't forget, we got this sweet merch still on there. I'll drop those links below too. And is there any other way to support the channel? Yes, if you don't want to buy a shirt or whatever, we also have a Patreon. You can donate as little as $1 a month to keep our train rolling here. Really helps out on these Tech Saturday videos for sure. Exactly. All right, guys. Well, let's jump into it. Roll that intro. First thing today, we'll want to point out that no one from PolarPro actually paid us for these this review or anything, so just full disclosure up front, right? We purchased these ourselves, so this is an honest, open, our personal review of these filters.
Right.
So the first filter we're going to look at is the NV8 filter.
I'll show you that right here. You can kind of see it looks pretty clear from there. Kind of looks a little bit like sunglasses if you really think about it. So what's the benefit of this ND8 filter?
If you're having a problem with like a bright day, it's like really sunny out or whatever, or the sky is really bright and you want to like help prevent your photos from being overexposed, because it's easy to do that on a sunny day.
Oh yeah.
Definitely slap this thing on and that's going to take that all out and help you out. Not a problem.
Right?
For sure.
Okay, so what if you want to do some sweet, you know, like sunrise or sunset shots? Sometimes, you know, it's really blown out, like one part of the sky is really blown out in one part of the video, right?
So, right, and if you slap a regular ND filter on, your ground at the lower level is going to be like crushed. You're going to like lose all that. So they have the option for that too. It's called a graduated ND8 filter,
and we'll show you that right now. Hold up this white paper for visual effects, but as you can see towards the top, it is kind of tinted, and towards the bottom it's you see there's no tint.
And so like anyone that does like sunrise sunset photos, which is like the sweet spot for photographers, you know, you're really gonna like that filter. It's gonna help you out a lot, keep your ground in focus and crisp, get all those colors and details there without crushing it with the ND filter.
Right.
And the third filter that you get is a polarized filter.
Yep, and I'll show you that right now.
There it goes, good focus.
So what's the benefit of a polarized filter?
So say you're at the beach and you really want those blues of the ocean and the blues of the sky to just like really pop out at you.
Oh yeah.
That's what the polarizer does. It effectively just reduces the glare and increases the colors that you're gonna see in the photos.
Or video, right.
So the graduated ND8 filter, we're gonna leave that one specifically for its own video to get you some sweet shots. And we'll test that one at another video. This one we're gonna focus on the standard ND filter, the ND8, and then the polarized filters.
Yep. Okay, so let's do some tests with this GoPro Hero 7 Black. The newest GoPro.
This thing is amazing, by the way. I just love the hyper smooth and the stability that you get with this thing is insane. It's awesome. But we're not gonna talk about that in this video. We're talking about these filters,
right? Okay, so what settings were we using on the sweet GoPro Hero 7?
Well, we kept it the same for all of them. We're doing 4K, 60 frames per second with the wide field of view, you know, standard GoPro stuff, right? That anyone would probably want to shoot, like if you're shooting an action sport or whatever. We also kept the ISO at like 100 min max for this. We didn't want that fluctuation or whatever. It was a little cloudy when we shot this, but with the GoPro, like the higher the ISO goes, the noisier the footage gets. So I just find anything outside with GoPro, you know, lock it into 100, maybe max 400, and then you're pretty much good to go,
right?
And we did have like the GoPro color enabled, so I find that's the most pleasing, like out of the camera view. Now that you can tweak that like a little bit more, but we're not going to get into that again.
All right.
You know, man, we're getting so many of these other things, we could probably do a whole nother video on the GoPro just on the settings.
Definitely, for sure.
Okay, let us know in the comments if that's something you'd like to see. Okay, so the first test was no filter, just straight shooting from the camera with the settings that Keith just mentioned. You know, the video looked really good, I think, just from straight shooting with cloudy day. But as you can see, the light on the top of my head is a little bit like bright. You can see
bright spots.
Really bright and kind of a little overexposed on your face, even on this like cloudy day with the ISO 100. Okay, well, I mean, that footage looked decent.
Yeah, it did.
I mean, it was okay. Like, don't be passable if you're just gonna slap that up for your YouTube video or whatever. Right. I think it'd be good.
Yeah.
But anyway, let's slap the ND8 filter on this and check that footage out right now. As you can see from this video, the light looks a lot more even and not as overexposed on here. But as you guessed, as a cloudy day with the ND filter, it looks a little bit darker than the first, but I mean, this is still a kind of a moody vibe you could go for, even on a cloudy day. And now on to the polarized video footage. So as you can see, the colors are much deeper and more vivid, and there's very little glare in this video. And my takeaway on this one is I really like the way that the polarizer actually makes the video look brighter, more vivid, and even colors. This, if I had a personal preference out of the three, I would shoot with the polarizer, even in a cloudy situation.
Right, no, I tend to agree. Just looking at this footage, it looks so good with the polarizer on it.
So I think the question is, do we think ND filters are a good purchase for your GoPro?
Our answer is yes!
We think since the GoPro is like inherently an outside camera, like action sports, or you're gonna be recording your boating or
right.
yourself.
Skiing.
Yeah, exactly. Skiing down the slopes or whatever. I mean, I think just in light of the fact that it's an action camera gonna be used outside, that's why I would definitely think that these ND filters are worth it, like worth a purchase.
Oh, definitely. I agree.
All right, guys, that's gonna do it for this video.
And also make sure you toss a like, you share it with your friends, and you definitely click that subscribe button.
And we'll catch you in 2 weeks for another Tech Saturday with Eric and Keith. Peace and love. So first of all, this is our... this is the standard indie 8 filter. Oh, I can't look.
ND8.
And now on to the polarized video, or
I wouldn't say vlog. Okay.
Why is it so hard to read when it's right there?
I know.
I think these.
I know, right?
Words!
The English!
Okay. So make sure you toss a like on this video, you share it with your friends, you click that subscribe button. It really helps us out.
Words.
I give up.
We can't get through this like one sentence.
Oh.